What on earth could an employee handbook have to do with my company growing? But you cannot run away from those stats. Over 2,000 businesses, 80% of the fast growers are on their game when it comes to employee handbooks. Only 60%, still the majority, but it's a 20% spread for shrinking companies. Companies who are not growing don't have updated handbooks. Well, take us through the root, what you think the root causes are.
Yeah, so, you know, we've had many seminars about employee handbooks, and to be clear, they're not mandated by law. But again, this is why I love this study that we took, because it's so compelling and it helps the employers understand one of the many reasons you need an employee handbook. So the first thing is compliance. And even when I have an employer that we start with, Mike, and they say, "Don't worry, Mary, I just had an attorney look at my handbook. I'm sure it's compliant." I say to myself, yeah, if an employment attorney looked at it, you probably spent $6,000 to $10,000. It's probably compliant. But what you need to add is, what are the best practices for what your competitors are putting in the handbook? And where's the culture piece? What in that employee handbook drives candidates, right? So when we're recruiting, are we sharing our employee handbook when we're close to making that job offer, so they see all the awesome benefits that we give, so they get an infusion of our culture and say to themselves, you know, that's really an organization I want to join. And then it helps us retain both our employees and our managers. It should make everybody's job easier to have an employee handbook, because any manager or a business owner that's listening can agree with me that they hear all the time from their employees questions like, how many days do I get off? When can I take an employee leave? What holidays are we closed? Right? When's payday? What leaves do I get? Those questions are asked of business owners and managers every day. If you have a document where we can be consistent, where we're kind of saving the time of the manager and the employee, it drives, you know, employee engagement, and it just makes for a more professional, cohesive culture. All around compliance and culture, that handbook is just, it's the first thing I start with every employer, because it's that important. And these statistics show that.
And Mary, something that, you know, everybody's going to get sick of me saying this, but I'm not going to stop. There's this chicken egg versus the egg kind of a thing going on here. I don't think we're sitting here saying that if the simple act of putting together a compliant, updated handbook is all of a sudden going to turn you into a growing business. The chicken egg scenario is here. Are you the kind of company that is proactive in your thinking about employee relationships, in setting clear expectations, having good policies that are in alignment with modern day employment and what the best talent in the market is actually looking for? So it's not the artifact in and of itself. It's the artifact of the handbook is really the result of how a company, a business, thinks about establishing relationships, hiring, recruiting, hiring, onboarding, training, retaining their employees. In the handbook is just the manifestation, the documentation to help set good expectations for what the real intent is. Anything you would add or some crack from that?
Yeah, I think that's well said, Mike, and I like that you made that distinction. And what I would add is, these eight categories are the eight categories I'm going to take every employer through when they're connected with Asure Consulting, HR Consulting. And so it's not just one piece, it's all of these pieces put together. And yes, you can have all these pieces and have a downturn in economy, or, you know, your competitor out, you know, bids you on price or whatever, right? So it is a complete, you know, holistic look at a business. We're not saying that if you do all of this, all of a sudden you know, your profits go up. Of course, we're not saying that. But what I am boldly saying is that if you don't follow these guidelines, with all of the good stuff, you might have an uptrend, but it's not going to go where you want it to go, because you can't do it without an engaged, productive workforce. And all of these eight items will put that together.
Yeah. So just to recap before we move on to the next topic. So 80% of the fast growing companies have an employee handbook updated in the last 12 months. 60% of flat and down year companies had an updated handbook. So it's still the majority, but there's a 20% spread. So 20% versus the 60%. So you're a third more likely to grow. Statistically speaking, you're a third more likely to grow if not you have an employee handbook, if you are the kind of company that really thinks through and leans into employee relationships, expectation setting, and policies and procedures that align you with the employee, and the manifestation of that is the employee handbook. So super powerful. I can't think of all the things, the ways companies spend money on hiring sales reps, doing marketing, product improvement, how hard you squeeze vendors to squeeze every penny out of margin. An employee handbook and this attitude to have a 33% chance of growing your company on one simple thing, this is it's just gigantic. And it sounds ridiculously simple, but it's because it's all about people, right?
Yeah,
all right, let's move on to our next
one. It is simple. It's a communication to your employees. It's simple. Just do it.